Students, this is class number 19. So look at this simple question on the board. A union A dash. A union A dash. What is A union A dash? It is nothing but universal set. So write solution. A union A dash is nothing but universal set. Universal set. Second one. Pi dash intersection A. Pi dash. Just before I told you, pi dash, complement of pi is u. Complement of u is pi. Pi dash is u. U intersection A. How much is intersection of A with u? It is A only. A. So if you have doubt, you cross check these things by taking examples. So next. So A intersection A dash, it is pi. So null set. A intersection A dash is always null set because A and A dash are disjoint sets. So A dash are disjoint sets. So last one. So U dash. Intersection A. So U dash means pi. So pi intersection A. So tell me how much is intersection of pi with A. It is pi only. I hope you understood this simple question, students. Let us go for solving. So one more question. Next question. So let A and B are any two finite sets. A and B are finite sets. Prove that. So number of elements in A union B. Number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. So number of elements in A, plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. So proving this is so easy, students. So I use this Venn diagram. So Venn diagram. Set A. So this is set B. Set A, set B. This part. This is A minus B. This shaded part is A minus B. Here you look at this. Here I have drawn lines. Line part. I marked this marked part. It is B minus A. This inside middle part is A intersection B. This is A intersection B. Number of elements in A union B. Look at this, students. This is shaded part A minus B, A intersection B, B minus A. From the figure it is so clear, they are all disjoint sets. So this shaded part is completely different from this common part. This common part is completely different from this marked parts. I marked this one more part by using lines. Marked part. Further, they are all completely disjoint. And union of these three sets should be A union B. Union of A minus B, A intersection B, B minus A should be A union B. That's what I am going to write. So A minus B, come on. So B minus A and So A intersection B are disjoint sets. Disjoint sets and union is A union B. Union of these three sets is A union B. So therefore, this implies number of elements in A union B, this should be equal to number of elements in A union B should be equal to number of elements in A minus B plus number of, from the figure it is so clear, plus number of elements in B minus A plus number of elements in A intersection B. If I collect, if I combine all the elements of these three sets, I am going to get elements of A union B. That's what I have done. N of A union B means number of elements in A union B. Further, look at this students. So we have number of elements in A minus B. So number of elements in A minus B is nothing but number of elements in A minus number of elements in A intersection B. A intersection B minus, I am going to get A minus B. So number of elements in A minus B is number of elements in A. Number of elements in A means I am going to get full circle. A under full circle birthday. Number of elements in A minus this common part, I am going to get A minus B. Full circle, common part over A minus B. So number of elements in A minus B is equal to, is nothing but number of elements in A minus number of elements in A intersection B. So and so number of elements in B minus A, same thing. Number of elements in B. So number of elements in B minus common part, subtract common part. So number of elements in A, so A intersection B or B intersection A. A intersection B is same as B intersection A. Using in one, you use this two in one. So write one, using in one, I am going to get there. So write. So therefore, number of elements in A union B is equal to, so tell me number of elements in A minus B. So it is NA minus N of A intersection B. Substitute for these two. How much is N of A minus B? NA minus N of A minus B. Now substitute for this one. So plus N of B minus A. So tell me N of B minus A. NB minus N of A intersection B. NB minus N of A intersection B. Last term. I substituted for this one as well as this one. You write this one down. Plus N of A intersection B. So now these two get cancelled, sir. Write the remaining. So number of elements in A intersection B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. Proof is over. I hope you understood this very well, students. It's so easy proof. So I have to just go through it once, so you will understand it easily. So next one, let's move on to next. So look at this, students. Remember the following. We have this formula. Number of elements in A union equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. Suppose if A and B are disjoint sets, if A and B are so disjoint, if A and B are disjoint, disjoint means no common elements. If A and B becomes disjoint, so that implies that A intersection B is a null set, means empty set. So if A intersection B is empty set, so tell me number of elements in A intersection B. So 0. So are there elements in that empty set? No. Number of elements in that empty set is 0. Substitute that. So this implies number of elements in A union B becomes number of elements in A plus number of elements in B. Right? If A and B are disjoint sets, this formula reduces to this form. If A and B are disjoint sets, this formula reduces to this form. So right, you remember one more formula. Extension of this formula. So right, extension of that above formula is, so number of elements in A union B union C. So number of elements in A union B union C is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B plus number of elements in C minus number of elements in A intersection B minus number of elements in B intersection C minus number of elements in A intersection C plus number of elements in A intersection B intersection C. So this is a extension of that previous formula. Extension of that previous formula. Proving this is so easy. You try at home. You represent, you take A union B, B union C as D, D, set D, and follow the same steps you are going to get. Surely you get that. It is so easy. So right. So let us try. Let us try this right. Students, let us try to prove this. Prove this proof they won't ask for your exam. So just for your sake, I am going to prove this. Let. So proof. Solution. Solution. Let. You take B union C as D. So I am representing B union C as D. This implies your LHS becomes number of A union B union C is equal to number of elements A union. I am taking B union C as D. So now you apply the previous formula. Number of elements in A union B, NA plus NB minus number of elements in A intersection B. A intersection B. Continue that. NA plus NB. N, what is B? B means B union C. Minus number of elements in A intersection B. B means B union C. So now, so number of elements in A plus number of elements in B union C. So NB plus NC minus N of B intersection C minus N of A. You apply distributive law. A intersection B union A intersection C. Idike distributive law apply maadi. So write A intersection B union, so A intersection C. So now again, so NA plus NB plus NC minus N of B intersection C. Again number of elements in A union B form. A union B, number of elements in A minus number of So I choose pocket 10. Number of elements in A and then union B.
Number of elements in A union B and then NA plus NB minus N of A intersection B.
So NA, number of elements in A intersection B plus number of elements in A intersection C minus number of elements in A. இது A, இது B, A intersection B, A intersection B, intersection A, intersection C.
What is A intersection A?
A. So, இது நோடி, A intersection A is equal to A.
ஏட்சரி பக்குலாலா.
Number of elements in A union B அந்து கொடி. இது இஷ்டு A அனி, இது B அனி. அவு என் பார்மடையில் NA plus NB. Minus N of A intersection B. What is A intersection B? A intersection B, intersection A, intersection C. But A intersection A is A.
Yet sari kalkabadi,
one sari kalkabadi saaku. So it is nothing but A intersection B, intersection C. Multiply by minus. Multiply by minus. So therefore, number of elements in A union B union C is equal to NA plus NB plus NC, NC minus N of A minus B. So write minus, multiply by minus, minus N of A intersection, B intersection C, order of order.
You write that in order.
So B intersection C minus N of A intersection C. A intersection C plus, minus into minus, plus N of A intersection B intersection C. I hope you understood, students.
So, right, let me see.
Let us solve this simple question, students. It's so easy. Solution: X and Y are two sets such that X union Y has 50 elements. So number of elements in X union Y 50. X has 28 elements. Number of elements in X it is 28. Y has 32 elements. So number of elements in Y is nothing but 32. How many elements does X intersection Y have? So X intersection Y, number of elements in X intersection Y, question mark. Just write the formula and substitute. So we have this formula. Number of elements in X union Y is equal to, tell me formula, number of elements in X plus number of elements in Y minus number of elements in X intersection Y. Number of elements in X intersection Y. Just substitute and calculate. 50. So number of elements in X 28. So plus Y 32 minus number of elements in X intersection Y. இது பேக்குரம் ஏ, this quantity required, I bring this sign, I send 50 right side. So this implies number of elements in X intersection Y. So 28 plus 32, 30 plus 2, 30 plus 20, 50, 58, 58 plus 2, 60, 30 plus 2, 20, 20 plus 30, 50, 50 plus 8, 58, 58 plus 2, 60, 16 minus 50, send 50 right side. How much is 60 minus 10? Sorry, 50, 60 minus 50, it is 10. Therefore, number of elements in X intersection Y is 10 elements. Common elements, common to both should be 10 elements.
So, okay, students, let us stop this class.
For your doubts, you call me or send a message. I reply. I will reply.